So today we're going to make a comparison of three very popular wireless hygrometers and thermometers. They do exactly what they say. Test and read the humidity and report back to a base station in your house. So I couldn't make up my mind when I was doing research on these, so I decided I need to get three of them anyway, and I'm going to evaluate them all and make comparisons. So I'll show you what models they are. I got them all on Amazon. I paid full price. This is not a sponsored review. I am not compensated in any way. I keep honeybees, and I wanted to put out several hygrometer and thermometer sensors in my bee yard, in my observation hive, and in my long Langstroth hive as well, so I will know what the temperature and humidity is. Now, you can't just get one brand and get 9 sensors, for example. So I had to get 3 different brands to get 9 sensors that would not overlap one another and read incorrectly. The first one that we're looking at comes with its own batteries. The other two I'm going to use my own, of course, Energizer Lithiums. They're the longest lasting, best batteries. And look at the temperature parameters, minus 40 degrees to 140 degrees Fahrenheit. 20-year shelf life, and they do really well when they're stored. Each one of these home base units had a little protective plastic piece over the front of it. And so you just peel that off. Illumination on all of them. They have channels syncing Celsius or Fahrenheit readouts. Only one of them will show you the day, but this particular one has magnets on the back, or you could put a screw on the wall. Since I'm going to use these inside, I don't care about the mounting portion. And this base takes 2 AAA batteries. And it'll freestand, or you can hang it on your wall. These are the batteries that came with it. Now, I want every piece of gear to have the same footing here, so I'm also going to test those batteries to make sure they're nice and strong. They also will mount your sensors on the wall if you want them. I'm going to put these inside feeder shims in beehives, so I don't care about the mounting. And I really just want to know when it hits above 50 degrees and if the humidity spikes up there. I also have an observation hive building. I'm going to show you that later too. So again, the back, they hold 2 AAA batteries. And then you can see the channel selector there. So channel 1, 2, and 3. And then, of course, there's the pairing button there with the TX next to it. So I want to make sure the batteries that came with it, who knows how old they are. Let's test them and make sure we're at 100% here. And we are. So we don't have to worry there. I am going to use the batteries that were included with it on the first unit. The other two units, of course, will get those other batteries. So that's how it goes in. Small unit, handy. It only displays one channel at a time of the three, and that's the upper portion there. The base station readout is at the bottom. I'm also going to show you a comparison of all of them because we're going to have the sensors and the base units inside in the exact same environment, and we're going to find out if they read true. Remember, these are not scientific. They're not super accurate. But I would like to find out what the ballpark accuracy is, and there are some things to know. So the other thing is, on the sensors that you put out, channel 1, channel 2, and channel 3, they're not identified any differently on the sensor itself, so I'm going to write that on the battery cover. On the outside there, it naturally selects and cycles through all three of them, and you need to put batteries in the sensor first, then put your batteries in the base station, and pair it up here by pushing these buttons. So this is the second unit, of course, channel 2 there, don't forget. And remember, you can't just buy more sensors. It only reads 3, and if you got 2 identical base stations, the sensors will overlap, they're on identical frequencies, and it wouldn't help you out. The other thing is, each of the 3 units and systems that I'm reviewing here are all on different frequencies, and they do not interfere with 2G or 5G networks. So now they're paired and operating. We have to leave them for quite a while here. It recommends that you let it sit for half an hour to stabilize, and then we'll see if all the sensors read out the same. That one's reading channel 3. Notice the down arrow to the right there. That means humidity. If it's straight across to the side, it's stable. If the arrow goes down, humidity is decreasing. If the arrow goes up, humidity is increasing. This is the WA54 AMIR unit. Now, these are cool because they're already marked, 1, 2, and 3. Nothing to do. In fact, of the 3 units that I'm testing here, the This is the most hands-off, easygoing one. 433.92 megahertz, and that's good because one of the other units is operating on a 300 megahertz cycle. This one holds two AAA batteries in the back, and there's no pairing to do. That's right, it's easy. It does it all on its own. So then all you need to do is make a log, of course, and document which sensors are going in which beehive or storage facility, your basement, wherever you want to do it. Three buttons on the top here, minimum and max temps that it records, Celsius and Fahrenheit button on the back. This is, of the three, the simplest. Three AAA batteries in the back. Super simple, no pairing button. You just turn it on and it goes, but remember, you have to put the batteries in the sensor first and the base station last. There's little holes around the perimeter. This is considered water resistant, so if it got some rain on it, probably okay. I would not put any of these out in heavy weather. You want them shielded. So inside beehive covers is fine for me. You see the little radio signs in the little right corners there flashing? That means it's trying to read the sensors, which now have batteries in them. It does take a few moments, and then they start showing up. Channel 1 is up, channel 3 is up, channel 2 still didn't report, so I had to repeat the cycle. I had to take all the batteries out of the base station, put them all back in the sensors, and then turn the base station back on by installing batteries. There is no on-off button on it. Also, you'll notice this display does not show date and time and things like that, but it does show all three sensors at a time. So that's kind of cool. So that's the smallest one, most hands-off, easiest to set up. And then here is the most expensive of the three. This is by Acurite 0604-3M model base station. Peel that display off, and it looked kind of weird here with the liquid crystal display there. You could touch it, and all these little weird things are going on. Turned out not to be a problem, though. So we're going to figure that out, and we're going to get this one going. Again, just show the exterior. This is the largest of the base station. You can click on the top there. It shows the records. As long as the batteries are good and running, it will store everything. All of these units are made in China. As I mentioned before, that's the Acurite. Very simple controls here, and you have a set button and then up and down to get you through the menu. This one uses AA batteries. So, and three in this one, and of course, two AAs in each of the remote sensor units. And there's a reset button there, which will clear all of your data and start everything off again. So if your batteries die, you're going to be starting from the beginning. And that's pretty much it, or you can just zero it out if things are reading wrong. The unique part of this is these are calibratable. So in other words, you can calibrate it if it's off a little bit, and it's the only unit that allows that. So here's the model number again for the receiver, which of course is different from the base station. They also offer each of these units with a single sensor. So if you don't need multiples, you're good to go. And these have, of course, nice, tall, large sensors. They have alarms on them if you want to set that. Again, those are all go through the menu and you can set that up. And again, there's your channel selector, that little black switch, A, B, and C. They have 20-year shelf life. Again, this is the Energizer 100% leak proof. That just means the batteries won't leak. But here's the key, the temperatures, minus 40 degrees Fahrenheit to 140 degrees Fahrenheit. Well beyond anything any beehive is going to do, so that's well within the parameters that I need. Also reminds you to make sure to put your batteries in the sensor before you put batteries in the base station. There's that little switch, A, B, and C. And the cover, so I have to write it on there. Again, don't forget to fill out your logbook or you're not going to know where you're putting these things and what the readouts mean. And so just 1, 2, and 3, I used an indelible ink marker here by Bic, fine point permanent marker, anything will do, Sharpie, you name it. And then here's the AA batteries, super exciting. And there's the three units. It also says on there that the range is 100 meters. I'm going to test the range of all of these, so stay with me. Also, while it's running, you notice those little red lights blink periodically. There's an audible alarm on the back of the base station, and you program the alarm, whether you want to hear it or not, and what the parameters are. Close up of the reset button. And that's pretty much it. That's the whole unit. Look, everything is displaying there. Notice the differences. everything should be reading the same, but remember we have to give it a half an hour or more to acclimate before we can really start to get critical about the readings. Hit the set button and hold it there, and you can go through the day, the month, the year, the time, all that stuff. So of course it reads Friday, 12 to 2 p.m. That's incorrect. Today is Wednesday, and I'm doing this at 9:01 a.m., and it's February the 24th. So we're getting these out here, and humidity is interesting to me because I want to know if the humidity is building up inside beehives. I'm not going to put the sensors down inside boxes with active bees because they would just plug up the holes with propolis. But I would like to know if their feeding stations at the top are going to get to 50 degrees or higher. Today they might, but everything should be reading the same because they're all on the same table next to each other. And look at the disparity. The base unit's at 73 degrees, 72, 72, and 71 for the remote units. And look at the humidity readings, 35 to 37 to 38. Quite a range there. This one, sensor A, B, and C, 72, 72, and 70, and the display is at 72. So 72 was pretty accurate, and that sensor C there on the right for Acurite, we can adjust that. So this just shows you the model numbers. This is what I paid for them. $32 for the Vivosun and $31.99, and then $59.39 for the Acurite. So the cheapest one is in the center, and here they are. They have been sitting out for more than half an hour. So this should be good. If everything were perfect, all these readings would be the same for temperature and humidity, but they were off. Next thing I wanted to do is find out what the range is. So I took all the sensors out, put them in my bee shed here. This is about 85 feet from where the readouts are on the kitchen table there. I'm going to put them all in the same room, so guess what? If they're in here together, they should read the same, right? So we get inside. Now I have a calibrated thermometer there, the traceable thermometer at the bottom, 71.8. The display on that Acurite was at 72, so within a degree. And then this one's at 73, and the one all the way to the left, the base station reading at 73. So within 2 degrees, that's not terrible. Remember, these are not, you're not going to hatch chicken eggs with these things. So I'm just making the comparison. Next thing I wanted to know is, how far can I get a signal? So I just decided to take a walk through the snow, and I'm going to bring the base stations with me. They're all wireless. How long do the batteries last? Each one of the batteries are supposed to last in each unit 12 months, it says. And that's the same for the sensors that are now sitting in that bee shed. So I'm just taking a walk, checking the signal strength on these. One of them said it was good for 100 meters. So I'm just going to keep going. Nice day for a walk in the snow because look at the outside temperatures here. We are hitting 49, 50, 51 degrees. Pretty good, considering we've been down in the single digits recently. So I'm already at this point 100 meters from the shed where the sensors are. Snow's a little deep. Might as well earn the cookies I'm going to eat a little later when I burn off these calories. But that little bench is what I'm going to set these on. Here we are. This is a good... Oh, it's well over 100 yards. And the signals, look at the signal strength on them. Pretty darn good, and it's still reading. Outside temp, 48 degrees. Of course, by the way, we can see which ones adapt the quickest to the outside temperatures. So Acurite adjusted itself pretty quick as we went. Vivosun seemed to do pretty good, and I think the slowest one was the AMIR WA54. So that's one lower left there. It still reads 71 degrees Fahrenheit. So it actually does take a long time to acclimate and catch up to what the temperatures are. Notice we have quite a range there, 48 degrees, and that's reading inside. So I took averages. What if we put them all together, the base unit and the sensors together? What did we get? Temp 72.6, 72.3, 71.5. So all within a couple degrees of each other. And humidity levels 36.5, 36.75. 33.25. So Acurite actually read the lowest humidity. Unfortunately, I didn't have a calibrated humidity gauge to validate that. But what we want to do here is show that they're all pretty similar to one another. Temperature range 67, 66, 67 all the way to the right. The humidity ranges were okay, not super tight. And remember, Acurite can be adjusted. So if you can take it to a pharmacist or somebody that's got a calibrated environment where temperature and humidity are regulated, you can calibrate your Acurite right there and then bring it home and know exactly what's going on. But for me, it's going to show trends. Increased humidity, increased temperature, 50 degrees or above. I know that my bees can get up there and start getting some of those emergency stores in the feeder shim. Thanks for watching. I hope this helped you make a decision.